Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. So recently I have been teaching you how you can start your own YouTube channel and how to make money online as a YouTuber. In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to create your own beautiful YouTube channel art or channel banner completely for free using Canva. I'm also going to link you to a template that you can get started creating your own channel art for free that I've created for you and I've linked you to in the description below. So it's really important to have a professional YouTube banner or channel art because when someone watches one of your videos, before they decide to subscribe to you, many times they'll click on your profile to go to your channel. And if they see that you don't have many videos there, or it's not very professional and doesn't look like you are a legitimate channel, they probably will not subscribe to you. But if they click on your channel and they see that you do have a beautiful banner and that you have a legitimate presence on YouTube, they are much more likely to subscribe to your channel. So in today's video, I'm going to show you step by step how to create your own beautiful YouTube banner using Canva completely for free. I'll also link you to a template that I've created that you can use to get started. And I'm going to show you how to use Canva even if you are a complete beginner. So before we get started, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one, and let's get started. Okay, so the first thing I want to show you is the YouTube channel art and how it can look different on different devices. So for example, this is my YouTube channel art for my main channel, and this is what it looks like on a computer. However, if you were watching this on a TV, it would look like this. You would see this full image here. So some people will make use of this space and add something like new videos every week, or you can just leave it blank like I have. However, if you were watching my channel from a mobile phone, you would not see the subscribe button or this arrow here. You would just see this portion in the middle. So what we're going to do today is I want to create a new YouTube banner for my other channel, Sparkle English. I've had this banner for quite a while. It's really basic and I want to change it. I also have a new logo that I've been using in my videos, and so I need to update this with my new logo. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to Canva. So Canva is completely free. There is a premium option, but you do not need the premium option to create YouTube channel art, and I'm going to show you how to do this completely for free. So you can join Canva by clicking on my link in the description below, and then you're just going to go to templates and click on YouTube channel art. I also am going to link you to a YouTube channel art template that's completely for free, so you don't have to go through creating and setting up all the guidelines yourself, but I will show you how to do that. So here you can see all these different YouTube channel art templates, and you can scroll and use any of these and edit them as you want if you don't want to go step by step and create your own. So what we're going to do is click Create a blank YouTube channel art. And this is going to give us the complete full size, so whatever we put on here will be visible on the television. However, we need to set it up so we have the proper guidelines for all the different devices. So the first thing we're going to do is click on Elements and just click on this square here. And we need to adjust this to 1546 pixels by 423 pixels. You can click here and zoom up and then try again. So the width, you can see, we want it to be 1546. Okay, and the height, we want to be 423. Again, if you can't get it exactly, you can just go like zoom up and then try again. 423, great. Okay, so now we're going to click on this and drag it and until it's centered, you can see with the purple lines. So what this is the space that is safe for the text and logo on a mobile phone. So a lot of people only use YouTube on their mobile phones. And so we want to make sure all of our important information is in this box here. So you can change the color of this. Right now, let's change this to this color here. And we're going to create a second box. We're gonna click here again and then change the color so we can differentiate the two. And we want to make it the height the same again. So I'm just gonna drag it so it's matching the height of the first box and then adjust this here, clicking and dragging so it's the same. So what we want to do for this one is make it 1855. So we're gonna, you can see 1855, perfect. And then again, we wanna center that so it's in the center, then right click,
send to back. So what we have here, everything that's on this first top box will be visible on the mobile phone, and on this blue box is what will be visible on a tablet if you're someone's viewing your channel. And then this part here would be on a desktop computer, and all of this on a television. So from here, what we're going to do is go File, Show Guides. And what we can do is create our own little guidelines. Now, you don't have to do this, but I think it's nice so you're always aware of what contents are in each box. So you just click and drag down, and then it will snap to the box. So let's just do that and create guidelines across all of the different sections here. So we have those two, then over to the side, click, put one line there, click again, one line here, and one line here. Okay, so in this part is the mobile phone, this part the tablet, this part desktop or PC, and all of this is the TV. So what you can do from here is erase these boxes or choose to keep them. I like to keep the boxes in case I accidentally move one of the guidelines. Now what I'm going to do is link you to this template in the description below so you can go ahead and start editing right away and you don't have to create your own guidelines. So this is the template right here that you can get started using. You can go ahead and put in your own picture here, your channel name, and edit any of the text box, and all the guidelines are set up for you. Just click Use Template. You will have to sign up, or if you're already logged into your Canva account, you can just go ahead and click Use Template. Okay, so now we're ready to start creating. So I want to change the background color, so I'm going to click on the background, go here, and choose whatever color I want. I actually want this to be the color of the background. You could also click on background and use any of these backgrounds or patterns that you want, or click on upload and upload your own image that you want to use. Now I'm going to click on this blue box and I actually want to make it a yellow color. So I'm gonna click here, add new color. I actually know the code color that I want, so I'm gonna paste it here. And I'm going to extend this box so it fills this whole space. Again, keeping in mind that the text and logo has to be within this space. And I want to change this to white. And one thing I want to keep in mind is sometimes we have these rulers, but when we're trying to crop things, see how the ruler can move and it can be a little annoying. So I'm going to turn that off for now by going to File, Show Guides, and then I can turn them on whenever I need them. But right now I don't want them on. I actually want to create a little border. I just think a little border is nice on the mobile phone. And I'm going to bring this like that. So now I'm going to turn my guides back on. And what I want to do is add my logo here and a picture of me. So to add your logo, go to Uploads and then click Upload Media and upload your logo. I already have my logo added, so I'm just going to click it and drag it onto the document. So you can position it wherever you want. You just click and drag on these nodes to adjust the size. And I also want to add a picture of myself. Now I've already cropped out the picture of myself and removed the background. So I'm going to go ahead and add that. If you don't know how to do that, I recently created a tutorial actually using this exact same picture, which I will link to in the description below. So you can go ahead and adjust this wherever you want. Now, if you want to make any edits to this image, click on Edit Image, and you can adjust the brightness, contrast, even add a filter. I want to add a shadow, so I'm going to click Shadows. And then you can either add a glow or a drop shadow. I like the glow. If you want to make edits to that, you can click again, and you can adjust the color, the blur, or the size. I'm happy with how that looks. So I'll click Apply. Okay, so let's add some text to this. We can go ahead, click on Text. You can click Add a Heading, Add a Subheading. I'm going to click Add a Subheading. Again, we want to make sure this is within the box here, so it's going to show up on our mobile phone. I'm going to put Learn and Practice North American English. And if you want to adjust the font type, just click and highlight it and go over here and adjust whatever font you want to use. I already know for my brand, I want to use Forum, so I'll click on that. You can also adjust the color by clicking on this box here and then adjusting the color. And for example, I wanted just this to be blue, so I highlighted it and then clicked whatever color I wanted to use. You can also adjust the positioning of it, even add bullets, or adjust the spacing, the line spacing, by clicking here and adjusting the line spacing if you want to give yourself some more space. With text, you can also click on effects and you can give it a shadow if you want, a lift, make it hollow. You can experiment with any of these effects. And you can also do the same with your logo if you wanted to add a shadow to your logo. Now let's say you want to add some sort of graphic. You can go here to Elements and there's all sorts of different graphics that you can use. Because I'm teaching Canadian English, I want to add a little Canada flag. So we'll go ahead, click on my little flag that I want to use and put it where I want it and then go ahead and adjust the positioning of it. Again, dragging on these nodes. And then to change the color of the elements, if there's the option to change it, the color will pop up here. So I want that to just match with my brand. So I'm going to choose this color here. So going back to my channel art for my current channel, you can see here that I have this arrow and it points down to these little buttons here. So if someone's looking at my channel on their computer, they could go ahead and link to my Instagram or my Facebook or my website. So what we can do is add an arrow in this box here. So I'm going to go ahead, click on arrow. And again, you can see if one is free, it'll say free at the bottom. And if it's pro, it'll say pro. But all of these that I'm seeing are free. I'm going to click on this one here. And I'm going to rotate it to 90 degrees. Change the color. Then you can just position that however you want here. And that way it will point down to the button. So you kind of wanted to get it as far over here as you can. So it'll will point down to these three buttons here. So that looks good to me. Okay, so this looks pretty good. Let's say if someone's watching on their television and maybe I want to put something up here or down here. Maybe I'm going to put some text at the top here and I will say new lessons every week. Change that to white. And then change it to my font type. You can even add in some embellishments. Let's say I typed in lines. Choose something like this. I'm going to use the arrow key to bring it up. You can click here even and change the ending of it as well, or change how what the line type is and change the color if you want. And then you can extend it as well. So let's go new lessons every week. And finally, I want to put a subscribe button down here. So I'm going to type in subscribe. And there's all these different subscribe buttons that you can use. Some of these are pro and then others are free. This one here is free. So you can go ahead and let's say scroll down and put that here. And if you click on edit image, you can go ahead and add any effect that you want to the subscribe button. Okay, and then you can turn off the guidelines just to see what it looks like. And I think this looks pretty good. But now to download this, just click here on download and then just click download. And this is what our new banner will look like. I'm going to make a few other little adjustments, but when you're ready to upload it, just go to your channel and then just click on your banner. And that will bring you to your branding section here under channel customization. And then here, you're just going to click change and then upload your new banner. And then you can see here what's going to be visible on all devices and what's going to be visible on the television. And then just click done and then click publish. And now we'll go to view channel and you can see that we have our new banner. I might make a few other little adjustments to this, such as taking this arrow and moving it up a little bit. But it's just that easy to create your own custom professional looking YouTube banner. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Please click like if you did. Make sure to subscribe to Jennifer Marie for more videos just like this one. And let me know in the comment section if you have any other tutorial requests for videos related to creating on YouTube. Thank you guys so much, and I will see you in my next tutorial.